Well, hundreds of babies die every year from a preventable health problem, shaken baby syndrome. Now, University Hospital is using a high-tech doll to demonstrate how adult frustration can damage lives in a matter of seconds. Wendy Rigby has a story, new at 5.
There we go.
Yay!
Good job.
Ian looks like any other two-year-old, playing with blocks and learning about his world. But his mother will tell you, every day is a miracle. When he was 6 months old, Ian was staying with an unlicensed daycare provider when the unthinkable happened.
He was throwing up. He had a really high-pitched cry, and, you know, like something was hurting him. So at that point, I took him to the ER.
Tests showed Ian had been violently shaken. Not only can the brain be injured, but blood vessels also break, causing bleeding between the brain and the skull and bleeding on the inside of the back of the eyes. University Hospital is trying to prevent such tragedies with an educational tool, this doll named Hope. If you shake the baby and the head flops around, the brain lights up, showing the devastating injuries you would cause. Shake the baby enough, and it stops crying.
Crying can be a very frustrating event when it goes on for hours or when it's unpredictable or when someone tries to soothe their baby and can't seem to find out what's wrong.
Baby Hope is a stark reminder that a few seconds of rage can be devastating to a baby. After surgery to get rid of the bleeding, Ian is now one of the 15% who survived his ordeal with no symptoms. His mother says she'll never try to save money on daycare again.
If I could go back, I would rather pay, you know, to have a certified child care provider rather than opting for, you know, trying to save money and having something like this happen.
The $700 shaken baby simulator was donated to university by the National Exchange Club of San Antonio. Nurses are taking it to high schools and teen pregnancy centers to educate young parents about the dangers of losing your cool. Reporting live, Wendy Rigby, KENS-5, Eyewitness News.
Okay, Wendy.